Well, the Paycheck Protection Program is just one of the ways that the government is trying to help ease the economic burden. Another way that they're doing this is through direct payment. So the government is sending up to $1,200 stimulus checks to millions of Americans. Many have already gotten their money via direct deposit, while millions more are waiting for those checks to come in the mail. Those are expected over the next couple of days, next couple of weeks. And for more on this, I want to bring in Claudia Sahm, a former senior at Federal Fed economist and also director of macroeconomic policy at Washington Center for Equitable Growth. And Claudia, thanks so much for taking the time to join us this afternoon. I know you're looking into how people are spending their stimulus money once they're able to receive this. You've conducted a survey with Google and also with University of Michigan to look into this. What are you finding at this point?
Right. Well, first, thank you for having me on this afternoon. And what we're finding so far is that people largely are doing with these rebates what they have done in the past, in particular in 2008. And really, whether they spend it or pay down debt or save it, a big feature that's an important feature of the rebates is you just give the money to people. They can decide, they know what their family needs best. And there are a whole range of circumstances, some that are very particular to this recession. Like, you're not going to get $1,000 and go out and buy a car, right? The dealerships are shut down. You're not going to go buy the washing machine. You may do that when the economy opens up. There are other cases right now where the government is sending out extra jobless benefits. So if you've lost your job, the unemployment insurance. But we know from the news that people are having difficulty making claims. Many of them haven't gotten their money. Well, $1,200 a person, that's an important bridge to get you through time when you get your checks. So there are some features of this recession that are very unique, public health crisis being an important part of it. But largely what we're seeing is people know what they're going to do with the money and they get it done. And so I just think it's a really important feature that we just got money to people. And what is so important about this and some of the other programs in the relief package is people are getting the money. Right. So it's not just been pledged by the government. People have it in their hands and they're using it.
Claudia, do you think it's enough to help spur some of the economic stimulation that was hoped for by the government at this point?
So sadly, nothing in the relief package, $2.2 trillion in all, is enough. Like, it's not big enough. It's not fast enough, but is absolutely important. We have a very severe recession. We are easily going to see 20% of workers lose their jobs. And so what the government can do, both Congress and the Federal Reserve, is they can take a very bad situation and make it a little less very bad. And they can provide a buffer when we get on the other side of this. The less damage that is done in the recession, the easier the recovery will be. It's going to be a really hard recovery, but what policymakers are doing right now is trying to get us in the best possible situation to get on the other side of this.
So, Claudia, do you think that more money then should be sent to every American?
So I definitely think more money needs to go from Congress out to families and small businesses, and state and local governments are in real need. So exactly how that happens, as long as there's money and it's going out and it's big dollars, I'm going to be in favor of it. I have always felt that it's important to get money to the people who are in most need, right? So the unemployment benefits, the food stamps, those absolutely need to happen. The people who are ill and sick and can't go to work, they absolutely need the money. I think that should be prioritized. I think from past experience and research, these payments to people that are, you know, $1,200, you know, $3,000 plus kids. I mean, this is real money. So it is useful. And I think the proposals to repeat this payment, whether it's monthly or quarterly, have real advantages to them. But I wouldn't want to see those replace Congress staying the course and providing the jobless benefits and the very direct relief.
Claudia, I also want to get your take. So we talked about the fiscal stimulus. I also want to get your take on the monetary policy that we've seen come out over the last several weeks. Now, you were the former senior economist at the Fed. The Fed's moves up until this point, how effective do you think they have been in helping stabilize the market?
So I think what the Federal Reserve is doing and has been doing over the past several weeks is absolutely essential, right? They are showing that they learned a lot of lessons from 2008, the Great Recession, the recovery, and they are applying all the tools they have, and now they're moving into tools that they didn't use in the past recession. I think early on, in terms of like, has it worked? We could see when the stock market started to decline that there were many different financial markets that had started to seize up. The Federal Reserve stepped in again and again in its lender of last resort. And we have a financial market, like broadly speaking, that's in a much calmer place. Like we're not out of the water. And I think what we've seen, and I'm really encouraged by them moving into lending directly to small businesses, and they're going to start buying municipal bonds. So this is really expansive and aggressive, and it's absolutely necessary.
All right, Claudia Sahm, thanks so much for joining us today. We really appreciate it. Great stuff.
Thank you.